Hello and welcome back to SaaS Bootcamp. This is week four, video four, and we are going to be talking in this video about merging data sets. So far in the past 3 weeks, we've talked about if-then statements, we've talked about deleting rows, we've talked about adding rows, we've talked about deleting rows, adding columns, deleting columns, so on and so forth. What we have not talked about is combining data sets together in SaaS. And really, if you are working on any health services research project, combining data sets, that is something that you will have to do on a fairly frequent basis, right? So in this video, we are going to talk about what are the different ways to combine data sets and how you can accomplish them within SaaS. Well, the first thing I want to mention when we are talking about combining data sets is that really there are two ways to combine data sets. You can take two different data sets and you can combine them vertically, which is you can just put them on top of each other, which is called stacking, or a vertical merge, if you will. Stacking is the more common name for that. Or you can actually combine them horizontally based on a key or an index variable, and you would call that more traditional merge, if you will. So let me first talk about how to do the vertical merge or the stacking, and then we will talk about the horizontal merge. So the way to do a vertical merge is actually really, really simple. You basically write your data step, and then you list all of the data sets that you want stacked in your set statement. Before I do this, let me actually introduce you guys to the data sets that we will be working with for the course of these merge videos, this video and the next one. So I actually have uploaded three different data sets to your SaaS Studio library, Merge 1, Merge 2, Merge 3. These are three example data sets that you could be encountering if you were working with administrative claims data. So the first data set actually has just two columns and five rows. It's got information on five individuals, ID numbers 1 through 5, and it has the gender variable for each individual. The second data set has date of births for these same individuals. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 individuals, each of them has a certain date of birth. The third data set that we are going to be working with is the office visit data set. This data set basically tells you what are the different dates that an individual went to see a healthcare provider. So for example, in this data set, it has 22 columns. Individual one went to a healthcare provider 3 times, once on 26 February, once on 13th August, once on 24th December, so on and so forth, right? So we basically have a data set which is not at an individual level, but it is at a visit level. So each individual can be repeated in this third data set. And this will create some very interesting merge scenarios that we will explore in the next couple of videos. So let's first do the vertical stacking, right? If you want to do the stacking, you just have to list all of the data sets that you want within your set statement. So I'm going to write stack merge one, and then class.merge two. That's it. And I just list all, and I can list as many data sets as I want here. For now, I'm just going to demonstrate two data sets to you guys. Let's look at a log. So the log actually here tells you a little bit more information. It will tell you that there are 5 observations read from this data set, 5 observations read from the second data set, and the stack underscore data data set has actually 10 observations and 3 variables, and this is what it looks like. Right? So we just took the first data set, which is these first 5 rows, which had individual ID and gender, and then we put it on top of the second data set, which is basically individual ID and date of birth. So for the first 5 rows, date of birth variable is missing. For the second 5 rows, gender variable is missing. So stacking data sets is useful when you have two data sets with the same variables and the same structure, and you're just adding more rows, right? Because when we talked about if-then statements and deleting and adding columns, we talked about deleting rows. We never talked about adding more rows to your data set. This is one way to do that. But stacking like this is not really applicable when the variables you have in the two data sets you're stacking are not the same, like in this example right here. So in these kinds of examples, doing the vertical merge, sorry, doing the horizontal merge based on a key or an index variable is actually much more useful. So let's talk about how to do that. Whenever you want to merge data sets, you first need to decide what variable you're going to merge them on. Because when a row from one data set is being merged with a row on a second data set, they need to be merged only when this key or index variable is equal in both rows of the two data sets. So you need to figure out what your index variable is. In our example, every single one of these data sets that I'm introducing you guys to in this video has a variable called BennyID, which has numbers from 1 through 5. So that's going to be our index variable or a key variable, which needs to match in order for this merge to occur. So the first thing you need to do for any merge is you need to sort your data sets. If you do not sort your data sets, SAS will throw you an error when you try to use the merge command. Let me go ahead here, say class data equals merge one, out equals, I'm just going to call it the same thing, but in the work library, by BennyID. Then I'm also going to sort my merge two data set. I'm going to sort my merge three data set as well, so that all three data sets have been sorted. I'm going to go ahead and sort all three of them. The output is only going to show me for the, I think, the first data set, but I can also look at merge one, merge two, merge three. Okay. I believe they've all been sorted. Now, let me show you guys how to do the merge. The syntax for a merge is also really simple. You just write a data statement, the name of your new data set, which I'm going to call merge one, two, which will be the file that merges merge one and merge two. Set merge one, So when you're doing the merge, instead of the set statement, you're going to replace that with the merge statement. You will not have a set statement when you're trying to merge two data sets. Merge one, merge two, and then in a by statement, you list the key of the index variable that you're merging them on, and then a run statement. That's it. Let's see how this works. Log looks okay. So you can see here five observations from work.merge one, five observations from work.merge two, and five observations in work.merge one, two, but now we have three variables as opposed to two variables. And this is what that data set looks like. So the output data set now has the BennyID, which was actually present in both data sets, but it's only present once in this merge data set. And then we have a gender variable, which came from my first data set, and a date of birth variable, which came from my second data set, right? So all of them have been merged on the BennyID variable. So the corresponding gender and the date of birth are appropriately matched, which is very important, right? So what we have seen in this example here is a really simple example of merging two data sets. The reason this is a simple example is not because, the reason this is a simple example is not because the code was simple. The code for merging data sets is this is it, right? It doesn't get much more complicated than that. You merge two data sets using the merge statement, and then within your data set, you can add whatever other commands you want to add here. So the code is not what is complicated. What gets very complicated when you are doing merge statements is having data sets not be really clean. The two data sets that I've shown here were really simple in that both data sets had an equal number of rows. Both data sets had this key or index variable with five individuals, BennyID 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, only one time in both data sets. And there were not any missing variables. There were not missing values. There were not any missing Bennies. This example of merge that we've just seen is called a one-to-one merge. This is called a one-to-one merge because every single row in the first data set of our merge has a corresponding row in the second data set of the merge. So BennyID 1 is present once in the first data set and the second data set. BennyID 2 is present once in the first data set, once in the second data set. 3 is present once in the first data set, once in the second data set, so on and so forth. If that rule is not met, it's not called a one-to-one merge. It's often called a one-to-many merge. And there are several types of one-to-many merges that we can discover if we try to link merge one data set with the merge three data set, right? So in this example, the file merge one has one row for BennyID one. The file merge three has three rows for BennyID one. Look at another example. The file merge one has one row for BennyID four. The file merge three has one, two, three, four rows for BennyID four. Right. Another example, BennyID2 is present in the first data set once. BennyID2 is actually not even present in the second data set. It's completely missing. So they never went to the healthcare provider, right? So often when we're working with health outcomes research and health services research, these claims data are messy. In fact, it is very, very rare for you to find one-to-one merges when working with healthcare claims data. You will often be dealing with one-to-many merges, like the example shown here. So let's talk about how one-to-many merges work within SAS. The code itself for a one-to-many merge is actually exactly the same. You don't have to do anything different with the code. It's just that the output will then be different. So let's see what I'm talking about. I want to merge merge 1 and merge 3 by BennyID. Oh, and by the way, you can merge, you can add more than one, more than two data sets in this merge statement. You can merge all three data sets at once. You can merge five data sets at once. In my experience, I always prefer doing two data sets at a time, because one to many merges particularly can get really messy really, really quickly, as you'll see why. And it's hard to know if the code worked correctly or not, or if the merge worked appropriately if you have multiple data sets that you're merging at once. So I prefer merging data sets two at a time, at least as you're getting used to merging data sets in SAS, and then you can start using multiple data sets later when you get more comfortable with it. Okay, so the code, as you saw, was the exact same. You'll see that we have 5 observations on the first data set, 22 observations on the second data set, and our output data has 23 observations, right? So one thing, the reason I'm reading out these number of rows is that every time you do a merge, be sure to observe how many data, how many rows were in the each of the data sets that you're merging. And then you need to identify, or you need to hypothesize, how many rows you will have in your output data set. If you don't know how many rows to expect, and you just take whatever you're seeing to be the correct answer, you might have an error in your merge. And those errors will not be errors that come out in the log. They will just be errors that come out in your output data set that you will miss if you don't look at the number of rows. So every time you're doing a merge, whether that is a one-to-one merge or a one-to-many merge, please make sure you pay attention to how many rows are present in each data set. So now let's look at our output data. So now we've got 23 rows in our output data set. And we'll see that BennyID1 has the gender variable and the visit variable appropriately matched, right? So the gender variable, which is F, now is duplicated 3 times because BennyID1 had 3 rows in the third data set, right? So now BennyID1, which was only present once in the first data set, basically got duplicated into 3 different rows in order to make this merge work. Because this is a one-to-many merge, the number of rows that each individual is duplicated depends on how many times they were present in each of the data sets. So for example, for BennyID2, who was present in the first data set but not present in the second data set of this merge, they are still present in the output data set, but the visit variable is just missing. It's missing because they were not in the second data set. Similarly, BennyID6, you'll see here, if you go to the merge 3 data set, there is a BennyID6 who went to the healthcare provider 4 times during this data period. But they are not in this data set at all. And we only have 5 people in this data set. So if you go back to the output data, you'll see that BennyID6 is present in the data set. They are present in there 4 times for each of those visit dates, but the gender variable is missing for them because they were not in the first data set. That is an example of a one-to-many merge. One-to-many merges, again, are really, really common within SAS, within health outcomes research. And you will find that most merges that you work with will be one-to-many merges. You just have to be really particular. One thing I like to do when I do merge statements is I will add a little comment at the end of my data step and say how many rows were in that data set. This way, when I'm looking at the code later, a few months down the road, or if somebody else is looking at my code, they know exactly how many rows to expect, right? And if they run this code and if they find that the output had anything but 23 rows, then they've probably changed something that made the numbers wrong. So I write that in a little comment at the end of my code to make sure people understand how many rows to expect as a result of that merge procedure. In the next video, we will talk even more details about different types of one-to-many merges and how to make those work within SAS.